Hi, my name is Dave Fricks. I'm a technology evangelist here at Qlik, and today I'd like to introduce the Cloudera Data Explorer that we're going to use to do ad hoc analytics of Cloudera data lakes.
So we'll go ahead and start in this application, which we can launch through a web portal. We start by choosing the metadata catalog that we want to use, which also gives us connectivity into that system. We make our selection and then start the process of investigating what data we have out of the data lake available to us. Notice the count of rows that we have, number of databases, number of tables, number of columns. We also allow you to use bookmarks, add filters, apply limits, search, apply metadata tags. Let's get started by choosing one database, click to go. Once I make that selection, the associative engine will now show me the tables correlated to that database. Choosing customers V5, we can now come over and see the list of correlated columns, which there are about 26 of them. Notice the green, white, and gray illustrating what's in scope and out of scope. Once I've made my selection, I can go ahead and add that table to the list of objects that I want to go and build a Qlik application on. Now next, I'll go ahead and use something that's pre-built. For example, I can come over and look at my bookmarks. And in this case, I'll use a predefined product table. Now I can choose my add possible. And once I've made that selection, I can see it's automatically added those entities for me. And then I can go ahead and add that table as well. So basic navigation looking at these elements. Now let's look at it a different way. Let's pop open a different window, allowing us to visually browse the data. I'll choose my Qlik2Go database. I will now see accounts of my rows that belong to that Qlik2Go tables. And as I make those selections, I can actually also come in and maybe I want to look at metadata tags. For example, I'll look at sales facts, for example, and it will now use input from Navigator to pre-filter my selection. So I want to look at, again, the only table that has relevance to that. I can now see the distinct value counts inside of that specific table. And once that looks good, I can go ahead and add the possible elements there and then add the table, and I've now chosen three elements. But let's investigate some of our other options. We've included the smart search bar where I can come in and look through elements like Qlik2Go, and I can just type in and it's got predictive text for customer and anything else that I type in, it will go and find that, including things like select statements or queries that have been saved. I can also go in and look through that information and look at all the metadata that's been captured, regardless of whether it's particularly useful. We've captured all of the metrics out of Navigator, Impala, and Cloudera Manager. Once we have that, maybe I want to apply a filter. Notice how it's smart. It knows what tables we've selected. It lists our field, and we can come in and do additional filtering. Now, this is a small data set, so we're not going to worry about that too much. I'll go ahead and remove that object. Maybe I want to apply a limit. Let's say it's a billion records. Well, I'm going to cap that, and maybe only bring in a million records. Now, as we went through, we noticed that this is relatively small, so we're going to just keep things as they are. It's going to start building me my Qlik script for me, and as we go through here, I can go ahead and see profile and see what's going inside of my tables, as well as my individual columns using all of the metrics that we've mined out of Cloudera. Once I see my information and it makes sense, I understand what I'm looking at, I can go ahead and just say Qlik create, and it will now go build this Qlik application for me. And once it says it's done and saved, I can go ahead and launch into that and start the process of doing my data prep. At this point, I see that I've got several different tables. I'll go ahead and let the engine sort them out. Now I know that my customer does connect up to my sales fact, so I'll just drag that in. Now I'll take a look at the join and I see that, well, it didn't exactly join the way that I want. That's fine. Just make another selection here. It fixes it. That all looks good. And I'll go ahead and do some work now on my customer table. I actually want to go in and fix my customer's field type in order to be listed as a country so I can do some exploratory geoanalytics. I'll also come into there and fix some of the data because I've got United States is what I'm looking for. What I can see is that I want to replace USA, United States, you know, all the different spellings with one standard value, which is going to be United States. So I can see that I've got New York, USA, USA, Puerto Rico. Those are all values that I want to track. So I'll go ahead and just, once I make my selections, keep those entities, and I'll go ahead and make those replacements. We'll now go through and do that mild data prep for me. Once I got the information that I want, I'm going to go ahead at this point and load some information. And at that point, I can just take that loaded data, and now I can start building my app. There's my new customer country, adding it as a layer. Go, you'll see it coloring. Now I can go in and throw in a metric that I want to track, for example, sales revenue. And there we go. With just a few steps, we've gone in and created an app out of our data lake from scratch, no coding, and now we're doing ad hoc exploratory analytics on our data lake.